Let us see working of unijunction transistor. Now, unijunction transistor, as its name indicates, unijunction means it has transistor which has only one junction, unlike our BJT or FET which has two junctions. Now let us see construction of unijunction transistor. Here you can see basic construction which shows here large, that is a big n type of silicon layer and small p type of silicon layer diffused in large n type of silicon layer. This p type layer is very highly doped compared to this n type of layer. Now there is symbol of our UJT or unijunction transistor which shows base 1, base 2 and emitter. Now this direction of this arrow, it indicates conventional current, that is current flows from emitter to base 1. Now let us see how this transistor works. Here is internal diagram of unijunction transistor. Here we can see this base 1 has a resistor RB1, this base 2 has a resistor RB2. Also from this P layer and N layer we can see here one PN junction diode is formed. PN junction diode is formed, which is represented by this diode. Now if we consider this as a silicon diode, then voltage drop VD across this diode is 0.7 volt. Now to turn on this UJT, that is to flow current from emitter to base 1, which is our conventional current represented by this arrow, we just have to apply emitter voltage here. Emitter voltage which must overcome voltage drop across this diode and also voltage drop across this base RB1, that is resistance of this base 1. Now resistance, voltage across this base 1 can be given by voltage divider rule. Here we can see we have connected external DC supply across this base 1 and base 2. Now to achieve our conventional current direction, that is from emitter to base 1, we must have to put base 1 at lower potential. Now to put this base 1 at lower potential, we have connected negative supply of battery to base 1 and also positive supply of battery to base 2. Due to this type of setup, there is small amount of current flows from base 2 to base 1 also, and voltage across this base 1 RB1 is given by RB1 upon RB1 plus RB2 into VBB, that is by using voltage divider rule. Using voltage divider rule, voltage drop V1 or VRB1 across this resistor can be given by VBB into RB1, VBB into RB1 upon RB1 plus RB2. Here we can see. Now this term RB1 upon RB1 plus RB2, also called as eta, that is our intrinsic standoff ratio. RB1 upon RB1 plus RB2, this term is also called as intrinsic standoff ratio eta. Now to turn transistor on, what we have to do, we just overcome this voltage, that is VRB1, which is nothing but eta into VBB, this eta into VBB plus the PN junction diodes which formed here by using because of P type of layer and N type of layer, given by 0.7 volt, or we can see VD. Now this much voltage, or more than this much voltage, we must apply, that is VE, that is voltage at the emitter must be greater than eta, this term, into VBB plus VD. That is this voltage and this voltage we must have to overcome, this voltage drop and this voltage drop we must overcome, and UJT can get turned on, and then large current flows from this emitter to base 1. That is initially the current from base 2 to base 1 also adds with this current, that is emitter current. Now let us see characteristics of UJT. Here we can see, now in these characteristics we have taken current on x axis and voltage on y axis. When there is initially zero voltage is applied, here we can see voltage is zero, then small leakage current flows through UJT, which is given by IEO. As we increase voltage, here we are increasing our voltage is on y axis, we are increasing voltage. At some point, what happens? This voltage VE becomes greater than this VE becomes greater than eta VBB plus VD. Now that voltage is also called as peak point voltage. Peak point voltage. Now until this voltage, our UJT is in off condition. UJT is in off condition. That is, current flowing through is UJT is very small. Emitter current flowing through UJT is very small. At this point, this UJT gets breakdown and large current starts flowing through device, and also voltage across device starts reducing. As voltage is reducing and current is increasing, this region is also called as negative resistance region. Negative resistance region. This region in which our UJT is in off condition is called cutoff region, and in this region where large current flows through UJT and voltage, on state voltage, reduces to VV, that is valley point. This region is called as negative resistance region. Again, after valley point voltage, voltage across device starts increasing and also current also starts increasing. This region is called as saturation region. Now, this negative resistance region is used to operate UJT as a wave generator or oscillator. That is, it generates repetitive waveform. This is our working of UJT. That is, at VP point, which is greater than eta VBB plus VD, then our UJT starts, UJT breaks down and large current flows through UJT.